listening to. You're listening to Obi.
Where'd that laugh come from?
Oh, sorry,
that was
sorry.
A profound statement
sorry.
I just
but
made.
You know but you know
sorry.
Something? Hold on. I want to hear his reason there, Patrice.
Well, let me.
You're listening to Anthony on the Virus Sirius XM.
Barack was talking to, I think he talks different to a group of black people than he does a group of white people. And he was in front of a group of black people, and he was talking, and
added on stuff.
It was a little, it was just, the message was a little different.
Instead of a regular up and down handshake, there's a little bit, couple of knuckles involved.
Yeah. It was more this, you can't quite put your finger on it, but he kind of was like, saying things like, well, you'll be able to tell your children that this is the time for change. And this is the time for healing our nation. Mm. I'm just thinking, oh.
Buzzwords for killing white people.
Well,
you are genius. How'd you crack the code?
He said, you'll be able to tell your children. He's addressing a black audience.
Uh-oh.
So you'll be able to tell your children, children of these black people, that this was the time.
But no, there was no TV around that he could have possibly been talking to every child just because there was a black.
No.
Now, when he's talking to an all-white audience,
yeah,
and he says your children, he's talking to black people on TV.
He's not addressing
He's not addressing the white people's children in the room.
But he isn't sounding as black when he's addressing white people in a room. I don't mean voice wise. I just mean there's subtle things. What do you think? You think I'm not perceptive to this?
Propaganda.
Do you think I'm not perceptive to this? This is not evil.
There is a slight propaganda.
There is a slight difference.
Stop your white fear. Stop. We're not planning to do anything to you.
I didn't.
Barack is not slipping. See, here's what you're doing that you hate.
What happened?
You're attacking inflections, fluctuations of his. Of his tone, you're reading into underlying
things. He's telling
black
people.
This guy is a well-trained politician. He's winning the South.
Well, of course he's winning the South.
He's winning Midwest things. People are not getting that vibe from him, man.
No.
Stop trying to get white people in the tussle.
I'm just saying, I notice these things.
You notice him saying our children and go,
It's the message that he was giving.
No black child to be left behind.
The message he was giving is that, hey, black people, this is our time.
This is slander what you're doing.
No, this is what...
this is slander. You can't even say this.
It's just...
It's slander.
It's not slander.
Stop.
I'm just saying what I feel he was addressing, what he was doing.
You're violating his constitutional rights.
You're not
accusing him. This is a witch hunt.
No, it isn't. If you would... You're too biased to open your ears and see...
I'm not biased to open my damn ear. I'm listening.
Yeah.
And that... Okay.
And there's a message...
I cut you off. Go ahead to the message.
There's a message going to black people that...
You finished.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury.
Yes, sir.
Your presentation just now was it?
No.
You had no more than, he said, black children. You got more.
No, it was that, but no, I have more.
White people are so genius.
Why has it got to be racism? Why is my opinion of what Barack Obama is doing on the campaign trail have to be racist because he's a black man and I'm white?
Opinion.
It is an opinion.
Slander.
It is an opinion. A lot of people, myself included, have said white America is not ready for a black president.
I agree with that.
Or a woman president.
I agree with that.
Now, this is a quote you're going to want to jot down because this is the first time I've said this.
When you say that's a quote you're going to want to jot down, I feel that you're talking directly to white people.
I am. I'm talking to white people right
white
now.
White people and their children. Go ahead. I just want to make sure
all right.
that I'm reading this right.
This is something I haven't said before, and I don't think anybody else has said before. I don't believe... Black people are ready for a black president.
Let me try to embrace a context.
I think your people are jotting it down already.
Okay. I believe you could have a point there in terms of what it will do is almost force black people to maybe make another angle as opposed to mm-hmm. race all the time.
Right.
So that a lot, I think a lot, and I agree, I believe in this, a lot of black people need the hatred that we have for white people to actually function mm-hmm. sometimes.
Yeah.
So if,
it gives you a common
ground. If we have a black
ground.
Person, it makes us a little different.
Yeah.
Also, that we might not want to be.
It's like, how racist a country can you possibly live in that would elect a black president?
But we would rather not have another old white man. Trust me. Trust me. We have come far enough to go, you know what, let's give a young black man a chance as opposed to another old white man who's done nothing.
Nothing? Look at where we are.
Where the hell are we?
Look at where we are. We're
in a fear that you have that the Unga Bungas are coming to get you.
Unga Bungas? Look, you say, the old white men, you're tired of what they've done. This country is the greatest country on the face of the earth.
I say these, there you go, slander.
Technology
again.
Is amazing. Would you rather it be like the Sudan? They got some great young black people in charge over there with dots and pickup trucks
They're
with machine
maniacs.
Guns in the back.
Are you?
I'm just saying.
Are you saying that slave hardened black people are the same as these maniacs running around with socks and AK-47s? That's what we are?
If you're going to talk about how old white men have turned this country into what it is.
Here's what white people and your boy.
Into a successful, prosperous nation.
The other day, your boy, that day was praising him and Norton.
Yeah.
This guy, you wasn't here. You were sick that day.
Yes, yeah, certainly
and
was.
And he's just going, we should go back to where people were people. When was that? The 20s? Where black people are unfairly treated.
You guys were having a blast at the Cotton Club back then. I saw the videos. You dancing and
we just had our little area. And God bless y'all. Y'all, you were you and we were we.
I'm saying black people aren't
You're
ready.
You're more reasonable than this.
Do you think a nice liberal, democratic Congress is not going to do everything this guy puts forth in office?
And what?
You don't think out of white guilt, out of not wanting to look like a racist, okay. they will pass a lot more of the bills he comes up with?
And there's none that would be, what, name a bill that would hurt you as a white guy.
That would hurt me as a white guy? Okay. Social programs that don't work, that are completely race-based.
And what programs were those? Because mm-hmm. you're saying it's like it's based on history. What, affirmative action?
Affirmative action? Welfare?
Welfare's gone.
Hey, welcome back then.
Welfare is
then.
Gone.
Then let me
There's
give
no
it a fond well. Let me give it a fond welcome back then, with my goddamn tax dollars.
The Negro welfare president.
Well, you know something?
Are you serious?
How else is his constituency of black people going to?
Black people are barely. He's not being supported across the board.
Are you kidding me?
Let me tell you something. The black
have you
people,
seen the percentages?
Wait, the black people that white people don't like the black people that white people don't like, which is Al Sharpton, Jesse Jackson, a couple of guys on Power,
right.
You know, that aren't really supporting Obama. They don't feel like he's black enough.
He's black enough. See?
He's not black candidate.
Yes, he is.
He's a candidate for black people because, look, why shouldn't we have our image? It's just like we have to look at Jesus that looks like he's a lead singer of a band my entire life, and he looks like Osama bin Laden. That's what Jesus really looks like.
Oh, show me a picture. Show me a picture.
And you see how unreasonable? Where does the Bible happen? He looks like an Arab.
He probably looks like an Arab.
We're comfortable. We will not take, and I don't want to drift off, but we will not take pictures of this long-haired hippie dude. Why can't we be comfortable for 5 minutes looking at a black president? He's not going to do anything special for us.
You know what? I'll give you a good idea why white people aren't comfortable looking at a black president.
Because they're racist.
No, it's nothing to do with racism. If we haven't
been...
Why do
I have to be comfortable with Bush?
If we haven't been being pointed at as the oppressor for so many goddamn years,
first of all,
years after that was even relevant to say.
Here's my problem with that.
Yes.
What you just
sure.
said.
Yes,
what
sir.
You just said.
Yes,
okay,
sure.
And I'm going to let you go. I just want to say to you.
Okay.
Here's my biggest problem with white people.
All right.
You're not all white. We don't. There's some weirdness with white people that your skin bonds you together and thinking that we all think you're the devil. Anthony, you're an Italian gambling drinking man mm-hmm. that lives in Long Island. You're not my oppressor. You're not the evil
no.
white man. A cow farmer in Nebraska who's struggling to just suck milk somewhere, he's not who I look at as the white man. But the way this country, the racism of this country makes average white dudes
mm-hmm.
think that they're better than me because they're white dudes, and they think that I think they're better than me because they're white dudes. You're not my oppressor.
That's never saying
it's
better.
It's a system that oppresses even white people that black people don't like. Poor white people are oppressed just like poor black people, but white people think that they're better than poor black people. That's the problem. We don't look at you like that.
You're listening to Anthony.
I see too many social programs that'll cost this country a lot of money.
None.
Don't tell me about the war. I know that costs a lot of money. I'm not for that either. Believe me.
I'm not for all
that spending.
But everybody, see, that's what I'm saying. Everyone's children are dying in the war. War is not a racial thing, except for, you know, who we're fighting. I guess it's racial, but when it comes to
unless you're in the United States fighting a war, it's going to be people from another land.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, I'm saying I'm not.
Yeah.
That's not a thing. I'm with you on that.
Mm-hmm.
But the country who's sending kids over there to fight is every color, every color.
Yeah.
And I guarantee some white lady's son who's dying over there, she doesn't look at it like her son the color of her son is more valuable than the guy that's trying to save her son's life over there. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But it's some weird thing going on where white people think black people look at you all the same because you're white. We just don't. So the black president's not going to do nothing to you. What the hell's going to happen? What's the black president going to do?
Are you trying to convince me?
I know I can't unless I spray paint you.
We're just going to have to see. If he does get elected, we'll have to see after a few years or a few weeks.
And you're ready to go. I told you so.
One thing. As soon as I start seeing news clips of a bunch of black people dancing around and saying, yeah, our man is in. You know it's going to happen like when O.J. got let off. It's going to be all like, our guy's in. Hey, it's time. This is going to be the change. It's time for the black man. That's what it's going to be.
Here's what we're missing with Anthony. We're missing what? Five white girls
mm-hmm.
Singing peaceful songs and one guy named Tex. and the Bianca and Tate Murphy. That's the same thing a young child has said.
You're listening to Anthony.
Diversity isn't something that is naturally inherent in people. We don't like diverse. How many white friends do you hang out with?
Have you ever gone out with a white person, a white woman, who mm-hmm. wasn't your ethnic background?
Yeah.
So it's a skin thing, is what you're saying.
No, it's not a skin thing. Look,
because that's diverse to date somebody outside your ethnic background.
I'll say this. White people are different if they're Italian, if they're Irish. There's a difference going on.
But if you dated
black
an Irish
people,
girl, you wouldn't be. You'd
it's
be fine.
Never just the color of skin or anything. Black people are different besides the color of your skin. Your interests, things that you do, things you appreciate, things that you're offended by, are different than an Italian guy or an Irish girl or something. So if it comes down to skin color as the initial thing, I'm attracted to pale women. What could I tell you?
SiriusXM, the virus. You're listening to Anthony.